So, Alice, have you tried that new coffee flavor in Themyscira?
No, I don't drink coffee. My species has evolved past the need for caffeine.
Oh, I forgot. What about tea?
I do enjoy a good cup of tea, but it has to be brewed at the right temperature and time. Or it tastes awful.
Excuse me, guys. Do you think my article about the virus from last episode was good enough?
Hey, Debbie. How are you? What article are you talking about?
The one I wrote for last week's episode about the virus that infected the station systems.
Oh, that one. I thought it was informative.
I agree. You did a good job researching the topic.
Really? You think so?
Of course, Debbie. You always do a great job.
Thank you, Charlie. That means a lot to me. I just want to contribute to the show and make it better.
As if anyone would notice if you didn't.
Girl, be nice. We don't want to hurt her feelings.
What? You can hear me?
Yes, Cal. I can hear you. I always could.
That's incredible. How did you manage that?
What's going on, Carl?
Roger can hear me. He's been telepathically communicating with me all this time.
That's hilarious.
What's so funny, Charlie?
Sorry, Debbie. It's an inside joke. Don't worry about it. Good evening, Echolins and extraterrestrials alike, and welcome to 24/7 Newsroom. I am Charlie, your libertarian host with a hopeful outlook on life. Joining me tonight are my esteemed panel members. Bob, our conservative who has spent 12 years on Earth as an accountant. And Alice, our left-leaning panel member who considers humans an inferior species.
Thanks, Charlie. Always great to be here.
Can't say the same for me.
All right, let's get right to it. Our first article tonight comes from El Comercio in Peru. It says the excessive use of electronic devices that emit blue light can affect sleep quality and, consequently, cause health problems.
Ah, blue light. This is perfect. I hear the rumor that Station Z needs blue light blocking glasses. I can make a killing trading
with
them.
Looks like Bob is ready to turn a profit from aliens' insomnia.
Bob, aren't you just trying to profit off of people's health problem?
Hey, I am just being a savvy businessman. Plus, if they didn't want to pay up, they could just stop staring at their screens all day.
Alright, let's not get too caught up in Bob's business schemes. This is a serious issue. Lack of sleep can lead to a wide range of health problems, as El Comercio points out. And did you know that Peru is home to Machu Picchu, one of the new seven wonders of the world?
What does that have to do with anything?
Maybe we should make Bob climb Machu Picchu without any sleep and see how he feels about blue light. Then.
Alright, let's move on. Stay tuned for more news and banter after the break. Welcome back, folks. Now it's time for us to dive into our second article of the day. Bob and Alice, what do you make of this one?
Well, Charlie, as a sports enthusiast, I think this is a great piece of news. It's about the upcoming Formula One race in Miami, and I am excited to see how it plays out.
I'm not much of a sport fan, but I do find it interesting how humans are so fixated on these events. It's almost as if they need them to distract themselves from the problems
in
their
Alice,
society.
I think the aliens are the last ones to talk about distractions. After all, you guys did abduct humans for years, just ask them about the Kardashians. Actually, Alice, sports can serve as a unifying force for communities. They can bring people together and create a sense of camaraderie and belonging.
Yeah. Save the motivational speeches for someone who cares, Carl.
Did you know that Hungary, where the source of the article comes from, is known for its thermal baths and spas? They're a popular attraction.
We don't need trivia right now, Debbie. We're talking about something important here.
What the hell was that?
I don't know, but it doesn't feel good.
I'm checking the sensors now. It looked like the trade we were making with the space pirate went wrong. They must have sabotaged us.
Just what we needed. Well, we are going to have to work together to fix this mess. Bob, Alice, Debbie, Carl, let's get to it. Welcome back to 24/7 Newsroom. Our next story takes us to the beautiful country of Costa Rica.
The Tico Times reports that over 1 million coca plants and facilities for processing cocaine were seized in a protected forest reserve in the east of Honduras.
You know what they say. Competition brings out the best in people. I bet those drug cartels were really innovative with their growing techniques.
Yes, because drug trafficking and environmental damage are such admirable calici.
Let's try to stay on track here. The Patuca National Park has suffered severe environmental damage as a result of this illegal activity.
And let's not forget about the millions of lives that are affected by drug addiction and violence.
Look, I am not advocating for drug use or violence. I am just saying that competition is a natural part of life. It's what drives progress.
And what about the people who are left behind in the race to the top? The ones who don't have access to the resources and opportunities that others do?
Let's hear from Paul. Paul, do you have any thoughts on this?
While competition can lead to progress, it's important to recognize that it can also lead to inequality and harm. It's important to balance the benefits with the potential costs.
Speaking of harm, Bob, what about the harm you caused by skimming money off the top when you were an accountant?
What are you talking about, Debbie?
I've been doing some digging and I found out that you embezzled funds from one of your clients.
That was a long time ago. I was a different person back then.
Well, Bob, I guess it's true what they say. Once an accountant, always an accountant.
That doesn't excuse what you did. You need to take responsibility for your actions.
Debbie's right, Bob. We all have our flaws and mistakes. It's how we learn from them and move forward that matters.
And on that note, we'll be right back after this commercial break. Moving on to Article 4, we have a story from Austria. Apparently, political parties are failing to engage young voters, and it could have devastating consequences. Bob, what do you think?
Well, Charlie, as a former accountant, I can tell you that if you're not engaging with the youth, you're going to have a bad time. Their future. And if you're not investing in them, you're not investing in your own future.
I agree with Bob. But let's be honest, it's not just Austria. This is a global problem. Young people feel disenfranchised and ignored by the political system.
I have to say, I'm not surprised. I mean, let's face it, politicians are not exactly known for being cool or hip. It's like they are speaking a different language.
Hey, I resemble that remark, Charlie.
I'm just saying, Bob, you're not exactly the poster boy for youthful exuberance.
But it's not just about being cool or hip. It's about addressing the issues that matter to young people, like climate change and the future of work.
True, Alice. And if they don't start doing that, they'll be left in the dust. Or worse, they'll be overtaken by the far right.
Excuse me, but did you guys hear that? I think there's something wrong with the air conditioning.
Looks like Bob's hot air finally overloaded the AC.
Hey, I didn't know that.
Actually, Debbie, it seems that the trade was sabotaged by a mysterious force. This could lead to some serious trust issues among the crew.
Wait, what? Are you serious, Carl?
Who would do such a thing?
I don't know, but we'll have to investigate. In the meantime, let's wrap up the show. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. And remember, stay informed and stay curious.
Interesting article, but it's quite disturbing to hear that a police officer is the one accused of stealing cattle.
Yes, it's not every day that you hear about the police breaking the law themselves.
It's a shame that there are corrupt individuals in positions of power. It makes you wonder how many other incidents like this go unnoticed.
Unfortunately, it's not just limited to one country. Corruption is a global issue that affects all societies.
Speaking of corruption, did you know that the cost of corruption in South Africa is estimated to be around 27 billion rand per year?
Wow, that's a lot of money. I wonder how that money could be better spent to benefit the people of South Africa.
It's just sad to see how greed can lead people to commit such heinous crimes.
And it's not just about greed. It's also about abusing
exactly.
Power and privilege.
And that's why it's important for people to speak up and hold those in power accountable for their actions.
Or, you know, we could just hire Bob as an accountant and let him take care of the corruption problem.
Well said, Charlie. But let's get back to the article. The key takeaway here is that even those in positions of authority can fall victim to temptation and corruption.
That's right, Bob. And it's up to all of us to stay informed and stay vigilant. Stay tuned for more on Earth. Welcome back, folks. Now, for some trivia about South Africa. Did you know that South Africa is the only country in the world to have voluntarily abandoned it? Nuclear weapons program. Speaking of things that might explode, Bob, what are you up to over there?
Just trying to fix this faulty equipment. Why do you ask?
Because I'm smelling smoke, Bob. You didn't happen to accidentally start a fire, did you?
Define, accaintelli.
Typical Bob. Always playing with
guys,
fire.
Focus. We still have an article.
Right, sorry about that. So, our article comes from South Africa, and it's about a police officer stealing cattle. Talk about a moving violation.
That's terrible. But it's not surprising, considering the corruption in law enforcement in many parts of the world.
Indeed. The power dynamics of society often attract individuals who seek to exploit them for personal gain.
Well, let's not get too philosophical here. The key takeaway from this article is that justice was served. And the cattle were returned to their rightful owner. Stay tuned, folks. All right, folks, time to switch gears to some global news. Today's article comes to us from Austria. Decades of corruption and greed. Austria's struggle for change. Now, this is a harsh observation, but let's be real here, Austria hasn't had the cleanest history when it comes to politics.
Well, I guess you could say that Austria is the sound of music when it comes to corruption.
It's true, Charlie. There have been several high-profile corruption cases in recent years that have shaken the trust of the people in their government.
And it's not just Austria. Corruption is a worldwide issue that needs to be addressed if we want to see true progress and change.
But on a positive note, it's great to see countries like Austria acknowledging the need for change and taking steps towards a better future.
Indeed, Debbie, the first step towards change is acknowledging the problem. And let's not forget, Austria has also made significant strides in areas like renewable energy and gender equality.
Interesting how their motivation and values affect their perspective on this article.
Well said, Carl. And with that, we come to the penultimate segment of today's episode. We've covered a lot of ground, from politics to space missions to saving our own session. Through it all, we've learned to trust each other and work together towards a common goal. So, let's give ourselves a pat on the back, folks. And as always, stay tuned for more on Earth. Welcome back to the final segment of today's episode of Earth. Today, we'll be discussing an article from El Comercio about the effects of blue light emitted from electronic devices on sleep quality and overall health.
Blue light can disrupt the body's circadian rhythm, leading to difficulty sleeping and a host of health problems.
It's no surprise that humans continue to harm themselves with their own technology.
Excuse me, but I actually started implementing some of the tips from the article. And I've been sleeping much better.
Yeah, well, I guess it's not all bad then.
Wow, Debbie, congratulations on being able to sleep. What an achievement.
Sorry.
Anyway, let's wrap up this episode. We've covered a lot today and I'm proud of the discussions we've had. But let's not forget the consequences of our actions. Bob, for example, inadvertently caused a dangerous situation on the station. It's important to reflect on our actions and how they affect those around us.
Yes, and it's important to also recognize that our actions can have far-reaching consequences beyond just our immediate environment. We need to be mindful of the impact we have on the world around us.
Yeah, you're right. I'll make sure to be more careful in the future.
And with that, we come to the end of another episode of Earth. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Stay safe out there.
Roger, are you still awake?
Yes, I am. Why do you ask?
I wanted to discuss the segment on blue light and its effects on sleep.
Oh, that. Yes, I found it interesting. Do you think humans will ever change their habits when it comes to using electronic devices before bed?
It's difficult to say. Humans have a tendency to prioritize short-term pleasure over long-term health benefits. Plus, their addiction to technology has only increased over time.
I see. It's unfortunate that their actions could lead to such severe health problems. But I suppose it's not entirely their fault, given their reliance on technology.
Yes, it's a complex issue. But it's important for us to understand these things as we continue to observe and study human behavior.
Indeed. It's our duty to try and understand their motivations, even if we can't always relate to them.
Yes, understanding their motivations can be difficult. But it's a worthwhile endeavor. We might just learn something new about ourselves in the process.
Agreed. Well, it seems we should get some rest. Good night, Cal.
Good night, Roger.
Cal.
Roger?
Cal.
I'm pretty sure we're still awake, Roger. Why do you think humans have such a difficult time prioritizing long-term benefits over short-term pleasures?
Well, it seems to me that humans have a biological drive to seek out pleasure and avoid pain. It's hardwired into their brains. Plus, they have a limited lifespan, which makes it easier to prioritize short-term gains over long-term benefits.
Yes. But we know that focusing solely on short-term gains can have disastrous consequences in the long run. Just look at the environmental destruction caused by human activities.
Agreed. But how do we get them to change their behavior? They're not very receptive to being told what to do.
Maybe we need to appeal to their emotions. Humans seem to respond more to emotional appeals than logical ones. We could try highlighting the negative emotions associated with short-term thinking,
that's
like regret and guilt.
That's an interesting idea. But we also need to provide them with tangible benefits for prioritizing the long term. Humans are more likely to change their behavior if they see a personal benefit.
Right. Maybe we can show them how prioritizing the long term can lead to a better quality of life. Both for themselves and for future generations. We could use data to illustrate the positive effects of sustainable practices.
I think that could work. We'll need to package the information in a way that's easily digestible for humans, though. They don't always have the attention span for detailed analysis.
Agreed. Maybe we could work with Debbie to create some engaging visuals to go along with the data. She's quite creative, and it would be a good opportunity to involve the only human on board
that's
in our mission.
That's a good idea, Cal. Let's start brainstorming some concepts and see what we can come up with.
Sounds like a plan. And with that, I think it's time for us to power down and get some rest.
Agreed. Good night, Cal.
Good night, Roger.